Today I'm going to be reviewing the TOOCAA L2 laser engraver. This is one of the largest, brightest enclosures I have reviewed to date. I'll be giving it the full rundown, the full testing. I'll be testing a range of materials. I'll be giving you the pros, the cons. I'll be showing you the software, and I will be giving you my honest opinion. If you're interested in getting yourself a TOOCAA L2, then you might want to watch this video all the way through from start to finish. But if you're only interested in a specific section, I will timestamp the video, so feel free to skip forward. However, if you do watch the whole video, it does support the channel, so please feel free to do that as well. This machine was sent to us by TOOCAA, but they've had absolutely no say in the video whatsoever. All of the opinions are my own, and they have had no editing whatsoever. So without further ado, my name is Chris, this is L3D Accessories, and let's get straight to it. TOOCAA L2 up for £827 for the 20 watt version I have. There are different versions and the base is 752. As you can see, there are 8 layers of safety. TOOCAA pride themselves on making a very safe laser. It is a class 1 laser. It has a smoke exhaust, gyroscope detection, lid open detector, a USB pin lock, a nitrogen gas ring, flame detector, and limit protection. So plenty of safety. Internal lighting is also there. So you do have to pre-assemble the enclosure that comes with it. If you're interested in seeing how to do that, look at the top. I've done a previous video and you're welcome to follow those steps through. Everything that is included is displayed right there. And we'll move on to a product overview now where I'm gonna give you a general spec. Pause it right now if you wanna take a good look or go to their website. But as you can see, lots and lots of high-tech features there. Now we're going to move over to the TOOCAA L2 overview. You are greeted by a little jingle when you turn it on, and that button is the resume button, the homing button. And as you can see, it's a really well lit enclosure. I like the orange. It's clear to see in there, which is really, really important when you want a laser because you always want to make sure it's safe. So the door is held up by pneumatic arms, which is a nice feature. And you can see they've got their own proprietary designed laser there. You can see all the limit switches and all the running rails in there and the gantries. A really clean interior, if you ask me. So we'll close that lid down and I'm going to show you the IO on the side, on-off switch, SD card, USB-C and power. And then you've got the USB security plug as well. On the back, they do provide you with a outlet hose and you put it on there. And I also got the air assist on mine. One thing I will say is there isn't really any clear routing. It just goes around the side, up through a hole in the middle, just goes in and then plugs into the laser. That's an area they could definitely improve on, but I'll touch on that later on. Now, I would like to show you the noise level tests. You'll see here, when it runs, it's an ambient noise, 60 decibels. That's because the fan is always running once it's plugged in. So unless you turn it off manually, you will always have that. If we look internal, as you can see, it's a lot louder. It's 76, I think it peaks at, which is quite a loud laser, especially if you've got it in a small office. So that's something to bear in mind and something to pay attention to. Like I said, you can only turn that off if you unplug it from the wall. So we'll move on now to the laser focus procedure. This is something that you do manually and you've got a nice arm that is part of that laser module. And then on the right, just a single lever, which is great. I love this. You lower it down until the arm on the left touches, lock it in place, put the arm up and you're good to go. So TOOCAA do have their own software called TOOCAA Studio, and I was actually pretty impressed with it. If you want to connect it, your laser will show up there. I didn't have mine plugged in at this point, but I wanted to show you. You've got your usual tools on the left, vector, rectangle, eclipse, circle, text. You've got a small shape library. You can also import your own files. I'm going to put a random SVG in here, and there you go. And then what you can do is you can adjust it as you want. There is a material test built into it. You don't get that very often. And then you can select layers like this. One other thing you can do is you can adjust the size and the position of it, as I'm showing you in the top left there. Really good to control it like that, so you know exactly where your engravings are gonna be. Now, there is a material library, as you've seen. We've got plywood, we've got acrylic. There wasn't anything in the metal library, so I was surprised to see that. There's also a PU, material magic box and other. So within those, you can find most materials. It's a good starter bundle. Hopefully they add to that as time goes on, but it's good enough. So you can also manually go in there and select line, fill or cut, and then you can adjust your settings accordingly. Really quite good intuitive software though. I was pleasantly surprised by this because in all honesty, some lasers that I've used in the past, the software that comes with their lasers hasn't been that polished, and it's just one of those things. So you can use this. You can also use Lightburn as well. It's whatever you prefer, but this is a free bit of software that they are adding to all the time. So now let's move on to the testing. I started off with some material testing. I'm going to let you guys sit back and enjoy this. I've tested a full range of materials, so hopefully you can get a good taste of what it can do. And I will include all of the settings just in case you want to replicate this yourself. One thing I wanted to demonstrate is the air assist on this laser, and as you can see here, there are some rough patches where I turned it off deliberately, and then there are other patches where I've kept it on, and you can see a really defined difference between air assist and non-air assist. I'll show you with the results right here. You can see the areas where I turned it off, so it's really, really effective, and really, really impressed with that. Overall, I was really impressed with what this laser could do with the different materials. It really did well on the aluminium business card. I have to say though, I did have to clean it off, but the dog tag I didn't. I did an engraving and a score on that, and the slate really, really popped. The image of me is great, a little bit dark, but it's still good. I could refine it all down, and the 6mm cut of the butterfly, absolutely outstanding. So overall, I was really impressed with it. If I refined those settings down even more, I'm sure we could get even better results. So now that you've had a chance to see the full testing and the full specifications of the machine, I want to run you through the pros and the cons of this laser to give you an idea of whether or not it's for you. So I'm going to start off with the pros. The first pro is that it is a really spacious and bright enclosure. As you can see right there, it really lights up. It's well lit internally. And having built it myself and having to assemble it myself, I got a real feel for all the individual components and the quality of them. And I have to say, the quality really is second to none. I was really impressed with the aluminium extrusion pieces, the perspex, everything is premium. And that's one thing I really, really loved about this laser. The air assist that I was provided with this machine was also a really, really good air assist. It isn't integrated in the sense that it automatically kicks in. Yes, you do have to manually turn the dial and turn it on and off. But what I will say is the actual efficiency of it during the cuts was really, really good. And I noticed a visible difference in it when I was integrating that air assist. So I really, really like the fact that that improved the cutting capability of this laser. I really like the laser module. The actual design was really sleek. It's a really nice looking module. It also has the integrated air assist mechanism, which allows you to mount it onto it really well. The thing I really like though is it had a retractable arm, and a lot of them these days don't come with that. You get a little block. This does also come with a block, but for most items you can use the retractable lever. And then finally, what I liked about that laser module as well is the fact that instead of two thumb screws, which normally you get with, and they're absolutely fine by the way, this actually has an integrated lever arm, which you unlatch it, and it's really simple to do. Quickly adjust it, latch it back up, and there you go, you've got it done. So it really speeds up that manual process of focusing the laser. And talking of the laser, we have the 20 watt laser, and I thought the laser itself was really, really good. The cutting aspect of it was very good. The engraving aspect of it was really good. I thought all of the engravings were really clear. I've had lasers in the past where they just, as much as they're powerful lasers, they aren't very clear, they aren't very precise. And that is a really critical thing when you're actually engraving things. So this one in particular blew me away with the accuracy of it and how well it performed during the whole of my testing. So another really good thing about this laser is it has an integrated fan in the back of it. So that fan helps draw all the smoke and the smells out the back of it. So if you do have an extraction device with your setup, you can literally draw it out and keep the area nice and clear, stop your office or your workspace from getting consumed with smoke and smell, and just generally improve your overall experience. This has the built-in fan and it works really well. So that is another great thing about this laser. Finally, the software that comes with this machine is called TOOCAA Studio. And it is a web-based software, but I actually really, really was impressed by it because I've used software from other laser manufacturers, and I have to say, a lot of the time, it's not very polished and they don't work when they come out with the laser. This one actually worked really well. I thought it had all the features you would need to get started, and it was advanced enough that you can probably do most things in it. And now we'll move on to the cons. So as I said, this is TOOCAA's first laser. They've designed this one from scratch, and as you can see, it's a beautiful looking machine. However, there are some design limitations which I believe could be improved for future iterations, and I felt like I needed to highlight them in the video. So the first one is this. So if you've got this machine in the same setup I do, which is the laser, air assist, and obviously the fan that comes with it in the back, that requires three individual plugs to do that because the fan itself is a plug that goes directly into the wall. The laser itself has a plug, and then the air assist itself has its own plug. That's a lot of plugs for one machine. It's fair enough, but at the same time, I think, you know, if you've got a limited amount of plug sockets or a limited space, that could be a bit of an issue. So trying to integrate things a bit more from that side of things would be a really nice improvement that could be made quite easily, I'd say, going forward. Now, I mentioned in the pros that the fan is a really good aspect, and it really is. However, there is one massive negative to the fan, and that is the fact that if you plug it in, it is literally on all the time. And I've measured the actual noise level, and it does significantly increase the running noise of the laser. Yes, you can unplug it from the wall whenever you're not using it. However, I was lucky in the sense that my power strip has individual rocker switches, so I could just switch off. However, if you don't have that, or if it's your plug sockets are in a difficult to reach place, it's a bit of a hindrance to have to plug it in and plug it off every time you want to use it or not, or you have to sit there with the fans on all the time. So integrating a way to turn that fan off or to have them automatically kick on or off during a laser process would be another really good enhancement that TOOCAA could add to this design or the next design that's coming to really bring up the level of it that little bit more. With regards to the air assist, it did a really great performance enhancement during the cutting. However, once again, the design aspect of it is a little bit flawed. And what I mean by that is it has a long hose which passes down the side and up around and into a hole at the back of the laser. And then once it's into the laser, there isn't actually any kind of routing for it. You just plug it into the laser module and then you have to feed it through as much as you can. And then that's it, it's hanging around. And I didn't have any snags whatsoever during my laser testing. However, there is potential for it to snag in the future. Yes, you could implement your own laser management or your own cable management on that. However, I think that's something that could easily be improved and implemented by TOOCAA going forward. Any future lasers, if you integrate that air assist into the laser, it's just going to level it up even more. You know, it's a great laser, but it will level it up that little bit more on top of where it is. So that leads me on to the big question, would I recommend the TOOCAA L2 laser engraver? And the answer to that is yes, I would. So this is TOOCAA's first design. This is their first laser they've come up with. And considering that, I mean, as someone who designs products myself, the first time is always hard to do anything because you are literally pioneering everything from scratch. But this is their first design, and I have to say it's actually a really good laser. I really enjoyed using it. In terms of the efficiency of the laser, it didn't give me any errors during the whole engraving process. It's laid out well. The internal layout of it is really clear. The lighting is great. The design is premium. Yes, there are a few design quirks, like the fan always being on, the routing of the actual air assist, and the free plug sockets, but they're design quirks, and they're things that can easily get around. You know, they're just nice to haves. They're not deal breakers, and that is the key thing here. So at its price point, if you're looking for a well-built, capable, user-friendly laser, this one is perfect, and it's definitely one I would recommend. Yes, there are better lasers out there, but there are also a lot worse out there. And to be honest with you, for the price point, you're not going to get much that meets this or matches it. So I would really recommend that. And finally, I just wanted to thank you guys for watching this video. I really enjoy making these review videos for you guys, and I hope they actually help you make informative decisions and decide what you're going to do. Because I know how important it is when you want to part your money. You need to know you're getting the right thing up front. So if you have got anything from this today, please consider subscribing to the channel. And also, drop a comment down below with any questions or any comments you have, because I always love hearing from you guys. So thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to making the next one for you guys.